going, everybody? That's right, you may recognize me from a game that just came out, Grand Theft Auto 5. I'm Michael, and tonight, I'm going to show you the unboxing of a collector's edition of Grand Theft Auto 5. So let's roll. First thing I want to show y'all, what's up everyone? It's Ross Boss. You dig the Michael costume? Totally did this for y'all. And tonight I'm doing the unveiling of the collector's edition of all this crap I got tonight. It's not really crap. It's a bunch of Grand Theft Auto. Don't even want to talk about the price I spent on all this junk. But I do have two regular editions right here. I actually popped one in so I can go ahead and get the install going while I'm doing this unboxing. Yeah, I think it'll. I bought these for some friends' birthdays that happened to be in September. Hey, if you know who you are, lucky guys, you were born in September. This is the limited edition Grand Theft Auto 5 manual. Who the hell needs a manual for a game anyways? I know I don't. But when it comes to Grand Theft Auto, getting all those pigeons, when it comes to Grand Theft Auto, this is something that you're not going to throw away or you're not going to get rid of in 2 weeks or you're not going to blow through. This is something I'll go back, like a compendium, over time. So I put that right there. I got a nice little stack right there. I'm going to go to that. Yeah, let's get to the nitty-gritty. What do y'all say? Let's pop this collector's edition. Let's see if I can take this glass off and see a little bit. Collector's edition Grand Theft Auto 5. You ready? There we go. Let me get a knife real quick. Had one set up. Before I go any further, let me just say this. After tonight's festivities of what the hell happened with me tonight, you know, I mean, you can obviously tell I'm not recording this right after getting it. The unboxing of this seems like it might be a little bit less intense than the night I've already had. So let's go ahead and cut that sucker. Let's get an eyeful on this. Let's continue the music. Let's bring it down a little bit, though. Let's try not to get, we don't want to get flagged or anything like that, so maybe we should turn it off and go some beat music. Alright, let's pop the sucker open. Here we go. Popped it open. First thing we got. Alright, it's a container. It's most likely a hat box, because it did say there was a hat inside collector's edition. Big cardboard box out of the way. Right now, it's worth so much. Probably in about a couple of years, it'll be worth nothing. And in a couple of years more, it'll be worth a shitload again. So there you go. Box is out of the way. All right, the big hat box, it looks like. Grand Theft Auto 5 Collector's Edition. Let's go inside. Holy shit, I can't have this in my house. It's full of drugs. No, I'm just kidding. Let's go ahead and put this over to the side. Let's go to the left side with this. If we're going to do this, might as well do it right? Feels good to beat it. GameWreckers.com. Make sure you check them out. Game Wreckers. They play the games. It's all about rolling them credits. All right. First thing popping out of the sucker is a hard edition Grand Theft Auto 5. That's a quick way to ruin that real quick. Grand Theft Auto 5 sealed case. Back to the knife again. This will go in the display box. Got three characters on the front. Pop it open. Got your map. Got your stuff. You know, I don't want to ruin this for y'all. Why would I want to go into everything? No, y'all got to open your own. I'm going to go into the further things. Collector's Edition Pack. This is the download code for all the crap. Like planes, stuff like that. This is the map. Should I open up the map the whole way? See what size frame I'm gonna have to get for this sucker. All right, here we go. It's going. I like how it's a blueprint. You know, it stays very nostalgic to that. Nice. Now, if you ever opened that before, especially if you've been drinking, you gotta know to take some care out of it. So there we go. Full map exposed. Looks like it's a 24. It looks like it's almost the same size as the posters, which is a 24 by. Yep, same exact frame size. I think it's a 24 by 18 frame size. Or 24 by 18. Who gives a shit? Go figure it out yourself. Go to Walmart. It's $10. Get yourself frame that sucker. Glad they put it to right size. All right, it's good to see. Oh, look at that. Look at that quickness. I saw some skill right there. Right underneath that, if you want to just get the game, just get the limited edition. Don't trust me. I got the key to City. I've got the key to apparently the offices of Grand Theft Auto 5. This is an actual key. I'll try it on my door later. All right, going further into it. Popping off the 5 plastic front. We're going in. You ready to see what's next? Oh, shit, I know I am. Boom, let's get a close look on that. What is that? See, I told you the hat box. We got the Los Santos. Look, it just comes straight out. Look at that. Oh, it just comes all the way out. Box is now empty. Everything's in my hand in a big plastic case. The Los Santos adjustable New Aero hat. It's like, don't even open that. No, look how fitted and prim that is. Don't open that shit. Underneath it, see if I can slide it out without touching the hat. Cause I really don't wear hats. I heard as a kid wearing hats will make you go bald. Funny enough, I wore a lot of hats when I was a kid. It's not that funny now. Underneath that was the Grand Theft Auto bank bag. And I only want to guess that the key I received earlier, you put your identification card in there, I definitely will be getting. Actually, how about we put that in there, right there, just like that. Nice GTA card, right? Already prepared. Got GTA on that side, now I got a card on that side. If you want to know where the card came from, I can't tell you. All right, apparently the bank bag definitely seems to be locked. There is something in it. So let's go ahead and bust out the key. Now, I ruined the packaging on this. I'll never get my money, but my money's worth back. All right, here we go. Now, this should work. This key thing should work for about a week before it completely breaks. So we're going to give it one good turn, and that's the only turn. Here we go. Pop. We got a pop on the bank bag. We open up the bank bag. Yeah, there's drug money in here. Okay, so we got our Grand Theft Auto bank bag, which is worth, from the looks of it, about $150,000, $160,000. So we're going to go ahead and seal that back up, put that somewhere where Morgan Freeman will find it in a couple years. Boom! Already locked back up. Nice leather lock. That seems pretty legit. Really? There's nothing else? I got this. I got a hat. I paid $160 for that shit. I got a case. Got a map. Now, this is going to be the big map. I did frame a Red Dead Redemption map. It looked pretty badass because I actually marked on the map where the hidden treasures were, which makes it look more authentic even. I marked it in black. I should try the same. But this is the basic map, which I really don't care about because I've got this for right now. But actually, I'm going like from Culture Shock. I'm not going to go with a map. Got more little ass instructions. Social club. If you have not joined the social club, I recommend doing it. My crew name is Born Without a Mother. So if you want to play with Born Without a Mother, you'll be playing with me. And it looks like that's about it for the Grand Theft Auto Collector's Edition package. You know, $160. You want it? Get it? Don't. Game's a game, right? Well, I'm the Ross Boss. It's been more than a pleasure. I'll see you online.